Hello and congratulations for getting to the end of this Getresponse tutorial. We have covered a lot and we started by signing up. We registered. This account did not have anything. We started by creating contacts. We saw how we can add contacts, how we can import contacts, how to deal with all these other things in contacts. Then we went on to forms. We created a few forms. We saw the kind of forms that you can create. We took those forms, put them on our WordPress website, put them on our HTML website. I showed you how you can have the link such that even if you don't have a website, you can just take that link and share it on social media, or you can even take that link and link to it on your website without really having to take the form on your site. So we did cover all of that, and you can go back and remind yourself how to do all these things. We also looked at messages. We sent newsletters. We learned how we can create an email newsletter. We created a simple newsletter. We learned how you can add PayPal. If you create PayPal buttons, how you can connect them in your messages such that when you send out your messages, people can click on the buttons and just go straight to PayPal and buy things from you. So we covered all of that. You can check that out in the section on messages and more about the email editor. The next thing we looked at was autoresponders. We saw how you can put it such that whenever somebody subscribes, you can send them messages after every couple of days. So if you have a goal that you want to achieve with every subscriber that comes into your list, you can do that using an autoresponder, a time-based autoresponder. And then after looking at autoresponders, we looked at how you can automate your marketing using Getresponse. So this is a very powerful feature. This is probably one of the most powerful automation tools in terms of most of these email marketing platforms. So we saw how you can create different workflows, okay? And I told you that you can even create automation for up to a year. Somebody subscribes and you just keep following them to see their activity and how they're interacting with your marketing emails. So I showed you how to do that, and you can go back and watch that bit. We also created a simple landing page. This I leave to your imagination. You can go here, create a landing page, and you'll see lots of different options that are available for you in terms of themes. We looked at landing pages, surveys. We created a simple survey, and then we looked at statistics. We said that you can see how your subscriptions are growing, and you can also see how your emails are performing when you send them out. Are people clicking? Are people opening them? So we saw all of that under statistics. And then, most importantly, under statistics, we created goals. How you can follow through and give certain pages values. For example, you have a checkout page. You can put a goal on that such that when you send out newsletters and people click on links and go back to your website, you want to track that. So I showed you how you can track that in Getresponse, and also how you add that tracking code on your website. And then finally, we ended by looking at webinars. It was a long video, but in the end, we sent out a message telling people that we are going to have a webinar. And then we went into the webinar view and we learned how to use all the tools in the webinar view. So by now, Getresponse is no stranger to you, and if you have any questions, make sure you let me know, okay? And I believe the knowledge will help you keep learning and keep growing. I will see you next time.